I'm going to load the reshape2 package and I'm going to melt the data. So I get here the typical result. So a column variable with the grouping variable and a column value with the measurements. You can use column names, you can use names, doesn't matter, I will use column names. So you say column names of hormone L is equal to drug and HC. That's more than one, so that is why you have to store it in the vector here. So when I run this line of code and I take a look here, you see that it has changed. The LM function, you want to model your hormone concentrations according to the groups, the different drugs. So you save the results of LM always in a variable. So I'm going to load the package. And then I can use this function. It will check normality of the residuals. Where are the residuals? The residuals are in the result of the LM function. It will check normality of residuals using statistical tests. So let's do this. And we only look at Shapiro-Wilk and Anderson-Darling. Yeah, these are the only relevant ones here. And you see that in both cases they have a p-value higher than 0.05. So yes, residuals are normally distributed. So we can go for the t-test here if you want to. Additionally, you can also use this function from the OLSRR package on the output of LM. What does this function do? It creates a QQ plot. So you have statisticians who like the QQ plot more than the statistical tests. And vice versa. It really depends on the statistician. So I'm showing you both. So here, what you should see is the points should follow the red line, the diagonal. And that means that the residuals, so every point here is a residual, that the residuals follow a more or less normal distribution. So the LM function will perform a t-test. But it makes a few assumptions, so the data and definitely the residuals have to be normally distributed. The data, the groups have to be independent, and the variances of the groups, the spreads, have to be equal. So I didn't check that. Levine test would work. What you can also do is just use the VARDOT test function. That performs an F-test. That's a typical test that you do when you have two groups that you want to compare. So what is special about the VARDOT test function? So the VARDOT test function needs vectors as input. So LM doesn't, LM nicely works on the data frame. But VARDOT test doesn't work like this. So for VARDOT test, you explicitly have to give him the two groups of measurements as a vector. So that's what I'm doing here. So I'm taking the column drug A from the original hormone data, so the white format, and I'm taking the column called drug B from the hormone data frame. That's what I do here. And then I can compare them using the VARDOT test function. And what comes out? The p-value higher than 0.05, so yes, the two groups have equal spread. You could do a t-test. You could tidy the outcome of the LM function. That would also work. And what also works, something that I just want to show you, you can also use the summary function here. So tidy would work from the Broom package, but summary also works on the output of LM. What does summary do? Well, it will give you the results. So you can see the p-value here. Yeah. So as you can see, this is the interesting p-value, the one you have to look at. So as you can see, indeed, he's repeating it here once more. Indeed, the p-value is lower than 0.05, so yes, the two groups are different. The t-value is also interesting, so that's the statistic. You also report this one. So a statistician would want to know it, but the biologist wants to know the difference between your two groups. Yeah, that's from biological viewpoint, that's the interesting thing. So the first estimate is one of the means, the mean of the first group. Yeah, the second estimate, this one is the difference. So this is the actual difference between the means of the two groups. The p-value alone does not tell you everything. Yeah, you can have a small p-value, but a very, very tiny difference here between your means. And then as a biologist, you might think, is it really relevant? Okay, so you always have to report both. You have to report the p-value and the statistic and the degrees of freedom. Yeah. But you also have to report the difference between your two groups.